Under the theme Understanding the Nutrition Policy Landscape in Uganda, the Nutrition Society of Uganda convened a multi-stakeholder nutrition dialogue spanning a two-day conference. Today, they engaged students from various universities seeking their perspectives on potential enhancements to Uganda's nutrition policy. Their involvement underscores the belief that students have a valuable role to play in shaping and refining policy design and development in the realm of nutrition.
Forum, where the leading institution in food and nutrition policy designing is engaging the public, engaging students, engaging the youth, engaging different developmental partners and academia, civil society. They're engaging us in a consultative dialogue regarding what we want to see in the food and nutrition policy.
During the dialogue, students and other stakeholders who attended the meeting voiced their grievances, which have impacted their knowledge and contributions to their careers and studies in the field of nutrition. One of the concerns raised was the lack of awareness about the policies governing nutrition in Uganda.
Students, I see there are very good nutrition policies, but we end up graduating maybe in Gauri. Have no knowledge about them, so I'm just asking why they are not included in the curriculum.
If there is a way our seniors can devise interventions of getting students to get more aware about these policies before we are done with school.
Reflecting 2018, we had about 647 nutrition graduates in the whole of Uganda. I don't know how many we currently are. So maybe as the students, as you exit the universities, please leave a record, because at a certain point in time we need to keep a record. How many professionals are we in the country? It's very important. And when we lose track, we are not able to say. For instance, if Charles says you have about 218 posts at a health center for, what percentage will that help?
There are some areas we have also good strength, because agriculture is the mandate is to give us food, nutritious food. They have Kawanda, they have Namulonge, they have all research areas. We want nutritious food, which has been done with the iron, whatever. So, like the sweet potatoes, the yellow we had. But they have to go deeper before releasing the variety of food. One, is it palatable? Two, is it nutritious? Three, has that food gone to the laboratory to test if there are those substances which cause cancer? Is it cancer-free food?
Alex Bambona, the Assistant Commissioner for Food and Nutrition Security in the Ministry of Agriculture, Animal Industry and Fisheries, emphasized the significant impact of aflatoxins as major contributors to malnutrition. Aflatoxins are silent killers, causing both malnutrition and economic losses in the food industry. It is imperative that we deploy our arsenal to combat this threat and improve malnutrition in Uganda.
Aflatoxin reduces income in a way, but at the same time also has an impact on nutrition, the food safety issue. Because you cannot sell anything. We have had a lot of problems recently in Uganda. We failed to sell maize to Kenya. We have failed to sell maize to South Sudan because of aflatoxin contamination. So the ministry is working around the clock. See how we can mitigate aflatoxin.
By 2025, the government of Uganda aims to achieve internationally agreed targets on stunting and wasting in children under 5 years of age as part of the Sustainable Development Goals. Additionally, by 2030, the broader goal is to eradicate all forms of malnutrition and cater to the nutritional needs of adolescent girls, pregnant and lactating women, and older persons. Story compiled by Jimmy Luima for the news.